With the rise of turbocharged engines comes a lot of confusion about the components and terminology that's involved with it. All the time I see people confused about what a blow-off valve is and how it's different than a bypass valve and what their car actually has. So today we're going to set the record straight. A turbocharger works by using the exhaust gases exiting the engine to spin a turbine, which has a shaft connected to a turbine that is separate from it, and that separate turbine compresses air and forces air into the engine. With more air, you can add more fuel and you can get more power. This is the whole idea of a turbocharger. Now, this is all fine, assuming that the throttle body is open and that pressurized air can enter the engine easily. Once the throttle body closes, all that pressurized air is going to have nowhere to go and there's going to be a massive spike in pressure. The spike in pressure can blow off intercooler piping, and it can also cause the turbocharger to completely stop or spin backwards, which will cause a lot of premature wear on the turbocharger. The idea of a blow-off valve or bypass valve is to get rid of this problem by letting all that excess pressure have somewhere to go once the throttle body closes. This works by using a vacuum port on the blow-off valve or bypass valve, which measures relative manifold pressure at all times. If relative manifold pressure drops below atmospheric pressure, that means that the blow-off valve will open and release excess pressure. The valve can either be mounted on the intercooler, intercooler piping, or in the case of a lot of modern turbocharged cars, it can be mounted directly on the compressor housing itself. A typical blow-off valve vents all this excess pressure to atmosphere. That means it takes all the pressure and gets it out of the system. It's not in the intercooler, it's not in the piping, it's not anywhere in the system. It's vented all out of the system entirely. This is what makes that iconic psh noise that we all know and love. One of the benefits to a blow-off valve is how quickly it can vent all that air out. If you're running a really high horsepower application, there's a lot of boost pressure, you need to get it all out very quickly, and blow-off valves are great at doing that. The problem with a blow-off valve is that venting all the air to atmosphere negatively affects throttle response. So for example, you're on a canyon road and you need to modulate the throttle. The back end suddenly stepped out when you were in boost, and you needed to modulate the throttle to help bring the back end into line. Well, when you modulate that throttle, you're going to release all that pressure to atmosphere, which means when you get back on the throttle, you're starting from 0 PSI. Now, this isn't a problem if you have a tiny turbocharger, but if you have a relatively large turbocharger, that means your turbo has to spool all the way back up and make all that power again. This can be really frustrating when you're on a racetrack, a canyon road, or an autocross course where throttle modulation is necessary. Now, a bypass valve is different in that it does not vent the air to atmosphere. It keeps the air inside the system, but it vents it before the turbocharger. So your turbocharger is creating all that boost. It's pulling in air through an intake tube. A bypass valve routes that air back into that intake tube to be then sucked back into the turbocharger again. In most cases, the air is rerouted back into the intake after the airflow meter, as that air has already been accounted for in the system. So if it were to be reaccounted for, it would cause some tuning issues. Now, bypass valves are typically used in production vehicles, such as my Fiesta ST, for example, because they are quiet and they are cheap to manufacture, and you also get really good throttle response, which is pretty important for a lot of production cars because the general consumer does not want to have to deal with turbocharger lag. The biggest drawback to a bypass valve system is that it can't flow enough air for a high horsepower application. The other problem is if it's recirculating that air, in a lot of high horsepower applications, there is no intake tube before the turbocharger, which means there's nowhere for that air to even recirculate in the first place. Even if there was a place for it to recirculate, it really cannot flow enough air to keep up with the demand, which means you're going to run into turbocharger surge, possibly intercooler piping blowing off, and a whole bunch of other issues that you really just don't want to deal with. The middle ground between all of this is a 50-50 blow-off valve, which routes 50% of the air back into the intake and 50% of it is vented to atmosphere. This means you get the really good throttle response of a bypass valve, but you're able to flow enough air for a high horsepower application, or at least a relatively high horsepower application. With more and more production vehicles using bypass valves on their turbocharged system, bypass valve spacers have become really popular in the aftermarket. What a bypass valve spacer does is space out your bypass valve away from its mating surface with a spacer, and on that spacer there are slots. So when your bypass valve opens, instead of it redirecting air back into your intake, the air is just let out those slots, which effectively turns your recirculating bypass valve into a 100% vent to atmosphere blow-off valve. The big benefit to a bypass valve spacer is how much noise it makes compared to the stock system. See, a lot of people want that turbocharger noise, but don't want to spend the money upgrading to a blow-off valve. So the simplest way to do that is with a bypass valve spacer, which will make your system much, much louder. Now, in theory, this should lead to worse throttle response, as you're basically turning a bypass valve into a 100% vent to atmosphere blow-off valve. But a lot of these production vehicles are using extremely tiny turbochargers, which means that they're in theory, there should be worse throttle response with a bypass valve spacer, but you're unlikely to notice any differences because the turbocharger is so small in the first place. All this information can be a little bit hard to digest, so all you really need to remember is that a blow-off valve vents 100% of the excess pressure to atmosphere, a 50-50 blow-off valve vents 50% of the pressure to atmosphere and 50% of it back into the intake system, and a bypass valve, which is what most production vehicles use, vent all of the excess pressure back into the intake system before the turbocharger and typically after the airflow meter. I hope this helped clarify some things for you guys. If it did, be sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.